Hi YouTube. Today I thought I'd go over some of my cameras and what I use them for and pluses or minuses of each one. I'm kind of unusual that I went with Sony SLRs or their newer models. Should be these three over here, which they call SLTs. But they all function pretty much the same and use the same lens mount, which is, these are all Sony A-mount cameras. And we'll start over here. This was the first one that I bought, and this is the Sony A200. I think I bought this around 1998 or so, and this camera still functions perfectly fine. And of course it's much slower and lower megapixels to the current stuff. I think this says 10.2 megapixels. But a lot of people get caught up in the megapixel race, and this camera still produces perfectly fine images. And the two primary things that I shoot are motocross and wildlife. And when I say wildlife, I mean like birds of prey, which are around where I live, or bald eagles and ospreys. And for motocross use, I mean, this thing, all my cameras live hard lives. I mean, it's a very abusive environment to use them in. And of course, this one here is much slower than the current models. I think it does like 4 frames a second. And a lot of people used to complain and moan like about Sony's proprietary memory cards. Well, this one only uses compact flash cards. This camera won't even accept Sony memory sticks. And this camera, it's specifically now, it pretty much lives inside my car, so I always have a camera with me, no matter what. But I don't use it on like a daily basis for shooting motocross or wildlife. And the lens I have mounted on, it's a Sigma Super Zoom. It goes from 18 to 200 millimeter. Not very fast. I believe it's f5.6. But I do still use that camera. Next, and the next one I purchased was the Sony A560. This camera was not in production very long at all. I don't even think 6 months. They made a upgraded model from this one, the Sony A580. This one at the time, it works absolutely fine. I do still use this camera often, especially for birding. It has a Tamron 200 to 500 millimeter lens on it, and has the Sony battery grip, so you can carry 2 batteries on it, and you pretty much turn this thing on and it'll run all day on those 2 batteries. And this camera focuses extremely well with this lens. And that's pretty much why I've kept all my old cameras. Of course, you can mount all these lenses are interchangeable between any of these camera bodies. But I pretty much marry one lens to one camera and keep it that way. Again, this one has an optical viewfinder, so you're looking directly through the lens when you're shooting with this camera. Speed-wise, I believe it's 6 frames per second. And again, just been another solid performer through the years, and very happy with it. still use it daily. Next, these are when they switched over what they call an SLT instead of an SLR. This is a Sony A65. There is no grip available for this model, but I don't find it's, I keep a wide angle lens on there. This is a 17 to 50 Sigma, but it is a constant 2.8 aperture. Use this camera often for motocross for wide angle shots. And you can see these do have a fold-out LCD screens on the back of them. Although I rarely use it because these SLT models also have electronic viewfinders. And anything that's viewable on the LCD screen is also viewable looking right through the iPort here. You can set it up to display whatever you want through there. So even to review your photos. So I never find a use for these LCD screens on the back. I've always shot through the iPorts and never the LCD screens. It's a side view of it. Yeah, this one does feature GPS, which really wasn't a selling point for me at the time. But I do find it pretty interesting. It's very accurate. Like, when you import your photos, and it shows you precisely where you were standing when you took that photo. Speed-wise, this camera will do 10 frames per second. And that's pretty damn fast. Even, I know Canon and Nikon are both much more popular than Sony, but only their top performing sports cameras will shoot that fast. And that is with continuous focus, and this has been another really good camera for me. And it is also, it's used many weekends shooting motocross for wide angle, and I've been very happy with it. Next to that one, this is the original Sony A77, which is it's an upgraded model from the 65 over here. It has the same image sensor in it, but does have additional features compared to the A65. The top ones I can think of are, this camera does 12 frames per second versus 10. And you can really fill memory cards quick if you're shooting at that speed. And I rarely do shoot at that speed. Just if you're shooting motocross all day, you're talking thousands and thousands of images by the end of the day to go through. So I rarely shoot it at that speed. The lens mounted on this one is a Tamron 70-200 f2.8 constant aperture. This is actually a very good portrait lens too, though I rarely shoot photos of people, that type of photography, but it is a good lens for that. And you can see this has an LCD screen up top. You can set it up to display various information, but again, everything is viewable through the iPort that I need to see. So, and again, the back LCD, and it tilts this way and that way and pulls out. Again, that's just a feature that I do not use. Just use the iPort for all my viewing. This one, of course, they do make a battery grip for, run two batteries in it. That actually kind of helps balance it too when you're hand holding it. This camera's seen a ton of abuse. It's been roosted on the lens front before from motocross bikes. But modern glass is pretty durable. And I do not run filters on the front of any of my lenses either. You'd be surprised. And I mean, this thing has been caked with mud on the front before. And cleans right off with no scratching. With no filter. Again, been very happy with this camera over the year. This one right here, this is the A77 II, which is an updated model of the A77. Did gain some features, but also lost some. Lost, these cameras no longer have GPS. But the feature they gained was they have built-in Wi-Fi. You can actually control this camera with your cell phone with the Sony Play Memories mobile app to run on your phone. So that's kind of a neat, I mean, it'll display right on your phone whenever you got the camera pointed at it. And this lens on here, this is also a Tamron. This is a 150 to 600. And it's f5 to f6.3, depending on what focal length you're using on it. But layouts on the back, again, very similar to the regular A77. I guess the A65, the A77, and the A77 II all do 1080 high definition video as well, with continuous autofocus, and that's at 60 frames a second. I should also point that out in the A560 too. This old camera here, this camera also does 1080 video at 60 frames per second. If that's an important feature to you. The thing I don't like about shooting videos with SLRs is all my previous, I should say 90% of my YouTube videos were shot with this camera right here. And you can hear this thing focus. You hear the lens creeping in and out. And that noise drove me nuts. And I'm actually shooting this now. That caused me to go buy this video camera. And this video camera I'm using is a Sony HDR CX440. Definitely not top of the line video camera, but it does have silent focus, and I do like that. And this camera I'm using, you can actually control it with your cell phone as well. It has built-in Wi-Fi. And all these other four cameras, these all use SD cards or Sony memory sticks for memory. And I run SD cards and everything, except the A200, which only uses compact flash. Next, I am starting to get more into video, and this is the Sony, I don't remember, it's the A200, AVS200 or something, it's the 200 series. Again, I bought this to mount on different motocross riders to give a onboard video. I went with Sony because all my other stuff here is Sony's. And comparing this to the GoPros, I think this puts out a better video than a GoPro. You don't have to use this with the camera, but this will actually give you a picture of what the camera's viewing, and this also contains the GPS for the camera, and record your GPS location. I've only used this once so far, cutting my grass, because I had to get some different mounts, and of course, they're not compatible with GoPros. And just waiting to go back to the motocross track to mount this on some riders and hopefully get some decent video. And I guess this is P a lot of people consider these cell phones cameras, but just I'm not never happy with the quality of the images that these things produce. And this one, this is a Sony Xperia Z, and this phone is actually not active as a cell phone any longer, but I kept it just to run my different cameras now, because it's a bigger screen than the current cell. I hate the size of this thing. It does not fit in my pocket easily, and so that actually kept me from actually carrying this thing around with me. And so I'd go phoneless many a times just because I didn't want to carry this damn thing in my pockets just because of the size of it. But this is the Play Memories app. And here you can see this. Boom. You connect it to your camera. Then you can control my different cameras with this cell phone. That's it. And my current phone is an LG model. Much smaller, which is a big plus to me. And I run the same apps. This is the Sony Action Cam app. It's specific.